These are made by David Lewis, who is a machinist at Allied Cycle Works. And he has turned up the precision game of the Marble Machine X by several steps. Well, if your heart doesn't beat a little bit faster from seeing this, maybe you should pay a visit to the doctor and look up if you actually have a heart. These are the pivot arms that are going to release the marbles. It's going to be an extension here that goes down to where the marble is released. And this is the pivot point. And this is a brass bushing. And I'm very big on ball bearings because I understand them. But it was inevitable for the Marble Machine X project to move further to the land of machinists, the holy glory land of machinists, where everything looks like this, and insert some bushings into design. And these are only going to pivot very, very little, so bushings is the obvious choice. We also want lateral stability this direction, so the thing can only move like this, but not sideways. And a bushing does that job much better than a ball bearing. Here is the previous design, and boom, these are the new ones. As you can see, they're much more airy and sleeker. These plywood pivots were causing a big heavy chunk wall here. Let's remove these and let's put the new ones on, see how that looks. Say goodbye to this junk. Look, it's a picture perfect. Flamingo. It flies out of the history of the Marble Machine X forever. Okay, let's check the fit. Perfect. Wow. Check this, almost no play. Laterally, like this. And pivots super light. It's a perfect fit. Before I can attach this, I need to remove this because I want to change this bearing to prepare for the next shaft size. This shaft is gonna be thicker. Why not make things more overbuilt if you can? I'm talking to you, Jeremy Schmidt, Mr. Building a Table to Hold My Vice. This bearing is going to be changed into bearing like this. Those belongs to these parts, which is an exciting assembly, but that's for another video. This bearing is put in with the strongest Loctite, and I've never broken a bond like that before, so I have no idea what to expect. But I'm using a stop collet to only hit the outside of the bearing ring. Let's see how strong that Loctite is. It's gonna give it one good whack with the mallet. Okay, Loctite is strong. One more try. There we go. That's strong stuff. Boom. So this is the strongest Loctite, the one that I don't think is meant to be broken. You can break it with heat, I guess. I don't really know how these things work. The spacing on the whole Marble Machine X between each channel is 21 millimeter. Marble divider, 21 millimeter. These should be 21. Okay, that's impressive. Can you read that? Seriously. So this support comes after 22 pivots. It's because all these pivots is going to the vibraphone. This is for the kick drum, one channel. The next, 24, is the second channel for the kick drum. If you've been following along, you know that we're doubling up the channels. Just like a drummer can use two hands to play on the snare drum, the Marble Machine X can use two channels to play on the kick drum. So we have the straight one, 30 degree angle backwards, 30 degree angle forwards. This is designed to make the routing of the connecting arms from here to the places where the marbles are being dropped easier. So it's just to take things away from each other. So 36 for the highest string and the last channel. Number 38. The last part to go on, the end bushing here. Let's see if the distances are correct. See, the machine is still shaking sideways. We are developing a lot of X cross supports. Okay, let's see if we can muster up enough of real estate. Have a look at that. That is so spot on. Machinists, I tell ya. So now, last problem, slide this shaft through all of these bushings. Ah, it's going. So from this to this. That takes us to the next step of this build. You remember in the original Marble Machine video, I was playing manually with my hands? I'm tempted to do a Hammond organ slide right now, but that would cut up my fingers. There are 38 channels, they all look the same. So how to know which note is which? And then I had the idea, why not make this into a little bit like a piano keyboard? So I thought I could use these ball end knobs, black and white to create a piano pattern to know which note is which. But then David came with a better suggestion. So these are black and white droplet knobs. Separate these a little bit, just ever so lightly. Maybe like that. Yeah, it presses on. Ah, that's cool. Yeah, perfect press fit. So, the pattern I've come up with is a little bit different than from a normal piano, because I have the vibraphone and it's not a C major scale, you know? It's a different scale for every song. So I'm gonna start with two white ones for the lowest notes. So my dad once told me the story about how Jeeves got hired. No clue why I'm telling you this now, but anyway, Jeeves saw an ad in the paper for a vacancy as a butler for some kind of lord, I guess. And he went for a job interview and he rang the door. And the lord was super hungover, so he opened the door looking like shit, right? So the hungover lord who wanted to hire a new butler tried to like say something, and Jeeves just held up his hand and said, "One minute, sir." And then Jeeves walked straight into the kitchen and whipped together some kind of magical hungover drink and went back out. I'm telling this story so badly. I'm so happy about my droplet knobs. So he gave the lord this magical hungover drink and said, "Please, sir, drink this." And then the guy was like, drank the whole glass, looked up at Jeeves and said, "You're hired." The reason why I'm laughing right now is because of the absurdity in me telling you that story. The story is great. I really slaughtered it by telling it badly. So I wanna play a C. I press that note. I wanna play an F. What the F? I wanna play an F. If this doesn't make your heart beat a little bit faster, maybe you should go to the doctor to see if you actually have a heart. Talking about British literature, have you heard Stephen Fry's reading the Sherlock Holmes adventures? Anyway, the adventures of Sherlock Holmes read by Stephen Fry. If you're in that British kind of mood that I find myself so often in. So I want to say a huge thank you to David Lewis from Veteran Bicycle at Instagram. You have taken the precision of the Marble Machine X to a completely new level. The design of this was a collaboration between me and David. I had the idea for the design, but he took the design and made it into something very sleek, something very elegant, something very airy, and perfected it with the Machinist expertise knowledge. So that is just so awesome. Here we have two threaded holes that we will connect arms down to the actual marble releases later, and these will connect to a surprise further on in the build that will fill this shaft over here. Seeing CAD come to life is an amazing feeling. Like Lego for grown-ups. I mean, what more can you wish for? Thank you so much, David, and thank you so much for watching. Should I try to make a Hammond organ slide? You know, vroom! I played Hammond organ in a band once. I made slides every... That's my absolute favorite thing to do. Okay, like, you know, when you end the song, and then the singer jumps and the drummer goes crazy on the cymbals before the singer lands. I can do that on the Marble Machine now.